Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. Previously, we explored a comprehensive tutorial series on Ethernet integration with STM32 microcontrollers. This series covered various aspects, including the utilization of raw TCP and UDP protocols, their implementation using the Netcon API, and the setup of an HTTP server. All these functionalities were demonstrated using the lightweight IP stack, which is integrated into the STM32 Cube package. Many users encountered difficulties in implementing Ethernet functionality, primarily due to complexities associated with LUIP. Challenges included managing DMA descriptors, buffers, and memory protection. Today, I will present a simplified approach for integrating Ethernet functionality on STM32 microcontrollers, the Mongoose library. Mongoose is a network library for C++. It provides event-driven non-blocking APIs for TCP, UDP, HTTP, WebSocket, MQTT, and other protocols. It is designed for connecting devices and bringing them online. On the market since 2004, used by a vast number of open-source and commercial products, it even runs on the International Space Station. Mongoose makes embedded network programming fast, robust, and easy. The Mongoose wizard simplifies the creation of professional interfaces without requiring design or front-end expertise. It supports user authentication with multiple access levels, which can be enabled effortlessly via a single checkbox. Additionally, dashboards are kept up to date with a built-in device connection indicator on the toolbar. UI controls such as drop-downs, toggles, and inputs can be easily mapped to C structures by adjusting getter and setter functions. Conditional display functionality allows data exceeding predefined thresholds to be highlighted using alternative styles. Moreover, Mongoose provides seamless firmware update support for microcontrollers like STM32, ESP32, and others, requiring no additional configuration. We will explore the Mongoose wizard in detail in the upcoming video. Today, we will demonstrate how straightforward it is to integrate the library with STM32 and enable Ethernet functionality. The tutorial section of the documentation outlines the steps required for library integration. Navigate to the Action Plan section for guidance. As mentioned, the first step involves creating a minimal skeleton firmware for the hardware board. Next, you need to add the Mongoose library and configure the TCP/IP stack. We will now review these steps in detail. The initial step is to develop a skeleton firmware. The documentation provides instructions for creating firmware across various devices. Since I am using STM32 with Cube IDE, we will focus on this specific setup. The documentation includes pin configurations for several boards. However, I am using the H745 Discovery board, whose details are not listed. Instead, we will refer to the schematic of this board to identify the required pins. The following steps outline the process for creating a skeleton firmware using Cube IDE. Developing a skeleton firmware involves configuring Ethernet pins, setting up UART, and optionally configuring LED pins. To begin, open Cube IDE and create a new project. For this demonstration, I am using the H745 Discovery board. Assign a name to your project and click Finish. The schematic of the H745 Discovery board provides helpful details. This board includes an integrated ST-Link, allowing the use of a virtual COM port for UART communication. The relevant VCP TX and RX pins are PB10 and PB11. For a detailed explanation of UART setup, refer to the UART video linked in the top right corner. If your board lacks a virtual COM port, you can use a USB to UART converter as an alternative solution. The onboard LED is connected to pin PJ2, which will later be used in this tutorial to control the LED through a web server. Now, let's return to the IDE. First, clear the pinout configuration and begin by setting up the clock. Select an external crystal oscillator as the clock source. The board includes an 8 MHz crystal, and we aim to run the system at 400 MHz. If you are using this specific board, ensure the power supply source is set to SMPS to avoid damaging the hardware. Next, configure UART. The VCPTX and RX pins are connected to PB10 and PB11, so these will be set up as UART pins. These pins correspond to USART3, which needs to be enabled. Set the mode to asynchronous and retain the default configuration. The UART will operate with a baud rate of 11,5200, using 8 data bits, 1 stop bit, and no parity. Configure pin PJ2 as a PO output, as it is connected to the onboard LED. This pin will be used later for controlling the LED. Next, enable the Ethernet peripheral. The board may use either an MII or RMII connection type. Refer to the schematic to determine the connection type for your specific board. For example, the H745 board utilizes an MII connection. It is important to verify the pins generated by CubeMX against those specified in the schematic, as CubeMX occasionally assigns one or two incorrect pins. In this case, CubeMX correctly generated all pins except PH6, Ethernet RX2, which should be PB0 according to the schematic. You can also consult the Mongoose guide for Ethernet pin configurations for your board, but it is recommended to cross-check them with the schematic for accuracy. Leave the parameter configuration unchanged. Next, open the NVIC tab and enable the Ethernet Global Interrupt. While enabling the interrupt, ensure that the interrupt handler is not generated by CubeMX, as it is already included in the Mongoose files. Uncheck the box to prevent handler generation. We have completed all the steps outlined in the guide. However, there are a few additional configurations required. Navigate to the Security tab and enable the Random Number Generator, RNG. This feature will allow Mongoose to generate a random MAC address for testing purposes. While the project can still be built without it, using the hardware RNG is recommended if available. Go to the PO configuration and associate the pin PJ2 with the Cortex-M7. This is necessary so that we can control the pin using M7 core. Once these settings are configured in CubeMX, click Save to generate the project. Next, open the Cortex-M7 main file. Comment out the code that waits for the second core to run, as we are not utilizing the second core at this stage. Continuing with the guide, note that we have already enabled interrupts in CubeMX, so no further changes are needed there. Copy the relevant code and place it within the while loop. To enable printf functionality, define the write function above the main function. This mgmillis function will monitor and track the number of milliseconds elapsed since boot. Finally, build and run the project to observe its output on the console. You should see uptime displayed in milliseconds. Let's proceed to build and flash the project onto the board. I am using the WCH serial monitor to view UART logs. The USB modem corresponds to the port for the STM32 development board. The UART configuration remains consistent with what was set up in CubeMX. Let's connect the serial monitor. On the console, you can observe the uptime being displayed, updating every 500 milliseconds. This confirms that everything is functioning correctly so far. The skeleton firmware is ready, and we can now move on to step 2. If you are using Kyle IDE, refer to this guide provided for the instructions. Next, we will integrate the Mongoose library into the project. Open this GitHub library link. First, open the mongoose.c file and copy its content. Then, create a new source file named mongoose.c, and paste the copied content into it. Similarly, access the mongoose.h file from GitHub, copy its content, and paste it into a new header file named mongoose.h. Next, we need to create a configuration file. Name it mongoose_config.h and insert the required configuration details into this file. Within this configuration, enable the driver for the specific board you are using. For example, since I am using the H745 Discovery board, I will include the driver for STM32H. Now that all necessary files are prepared, include the standard I/O header file as recommended by the IDE, along with the mongoose.h header file. Afterward, create a function called runMongoose. Place this function above the main function for better organization. In addition to these steps, we need to implement a function that generates a random number for the MAC address. This function will utilize the hardware's random number generator. Once done, build the project. If you encounter an error indicating multiple definitions of mgrandom, it's because this function is already defined in the Mongoose source file. To resolve this, configure the library to use your custom random function by enabling custom random in the configuration file. Rebuild the project after making this change. If successful, the library will now use your custom random function. Finally, call the runMongoose function before entering the infinite loop in your program. Note that the while loop won't execute anymore because runMongoose contains its own infinite loop to handle network events. Build and flash your project onto the board. After flashing, check the logs on the serial console. You should see that a random MAC address has been generated for your board. If no further logs appear, it could indicate that something is stuck. Upon investigation, I found that this issue was caused by an incorrect PHY address. To fix this, set the PHY address to 1 in the configuration file. The address typically ranges from 0 to 4, for STM32H and F-series devices, it is usually set to 0 by default. However, if your board doesn't work with 0, try setting it to 1 as I did. Rebuild and flash your project again. Check the logs once more on your console. If everything works correctly now, but you still don't see an IP address, it may be because your Ethernet cable is connected directly to your computer instead of a router. The library uses DHCP by default, so connecting through a router would assign an IP address automatically as shown in guides. However, if you're connecting directly to a computer without a router in between, you'll need to configure a static IP instead. To define a static IP, we will configure it directly in the mongoose.config.h file. For this setup, I am assigning the IP address 192.168.0.10. Alongside the IP, the gateway and netmask values are also specified. With these changes, the Mongoose library will use the static IP instead of relying on DHCP. Next, we need to adjust the Ethernet settings on the computer. I am currently using a Mac, but I will also include instructions for Windows in the article linked in the video description. By default, Ethernet is set to use DHCP, so we need to switch it to manual configuration. Assign an IP address to the computer that is greater than the gateway address defined earlier in mongoose.config.h. Set the subnet mask to 255.255.255.0, and set the DNS to 0. Once the Ethernet settings are configured to match those on STM32, flash the project onto the board again. You should now see the assigned static IP address in the logs. Since a static IP is being used, there's no need to monitor logs further, the TCP/IP stack is functioning correctly. To verify connectivity, ping the assigned IP address from your computer. You should see responses from the board, confirming that the TCP/IP stack is operational. Now let's proceed with additional tasks. Step 3 in the guide involves creating a simple web server. To achieve this, start by adding an HTTP listener within the run Mongoose function before its infinite loop. Then, include an event handler above run Mongoose to manage incoming HTTP requests. This handler will respond with OK and display uptime information. Build and flash your project onto the board again. Open a browser and navigate to your server's IP address. You should see uptime details displayed on the web page. The uptime updates every time we refresh the page. So the simple web server is fine. Next, implement a basic web UI to control an onboard LED via this server. Replace the existing event handler with new code that manages LED state based on HTTP requests. Ensure you specify the correct QO pin for your LED. In my case, it's connected to pin PJ2. Update your configuration file by adding two specific lines required for this functionality. Then visit a provided link to generate a packed file system source file for your web UI. Create a new file named packedfs.c in your source folder and paste this content into it. Rebuild and flash your project once more. Refresh your web server page in the browser. You should see a new UI for controlling the LED. The LED will be on by default. Toggle it via this interface to turn it off or on as desired. This implementation demonstrates how easy it is to control hardware components like LEDs over Ethernet using Mongoose compared to alternatives like LWIP. We successfully set up a TCP/IP stack and created a web server using Mongoose on STM32. Additionally, I've discussed common errors you might encounter and their resolutions during development. Mongoose also provides a wizard for generating complete web UIs with multiple pages, along with pre-built projects for STM32 Cubide tailored to various STM32 boards. These can be imported directly into Cube IDE and integrated with physical sensors or other devices. We'll explore this project wizard in detail in our next video of this series. For now, you can download this project using the link provided in the description below. Feel free to leave comments if you have questions or need clarification. Thank you for watching, have a great day ahead.